right now. You just go into praise and worship right now. And begin to really just meditate on God. Call upon His name. Talk to Him. Love on God.
Shower down, shower down, hallelujah. Because acting in the manner that the Holy Spirit is going on in this place. And God is about to pour out a blessing. But the thing about when God pours out this blessing into our lives, get ready, because He's going to overflow you that you have no room enough to store inside. I wish I had a witness in this place. What are you saying, Pastor? Because when God begins to bless you, He's not going to just stop at one thing. He's going to continue to bless you, continue to bless you. Things that you've been wanting to be solved in your life is going to be fixed right now in the name of Jesus. He said, but if you only surrender, it'll happen to you. It'll happen to you. The crazy thing is that if you follow God's will, okay, here you go. If you follow God's will, He'll handle everything else. What are you saying, Pastor? Well, even into my personal life, and even with church, God said, if you put it into my hands, I'll take care of the rest. So I put it in God's hands, and now we have a 200-seat sanctuary. See, that's something to be excited about right there. Hallelujah. Yeah. See, that's what God does. Not just a 200-seat sanctuary that we can worship freely, but a recreational facility for such as playing sports in the gym. All for us. Someone says for us.
Thank you, God.
Man, I need to let you know what God has for you is for you. And nobody can take it away. But here's the thing. When God gives you something, baby, get ready for the storm. Get ready for the hurricanes. Get ready for hell to come your way. So God's saying, baby, while I'm blessing you, don't get comfortable yet. Freedom, when we go into this new sanctuary, don't get comfortable yet. Because we got more we got to do. You got a bigger space, that means more work.
Was his friends, everyone that he thought was
why have you forsaken me? Why have you forsaken me? I can imagine what that took place from there, because I know who that could be. Because see, sometimes we worry about ourselves and we don't look at the big picture. So I can see God saying, son, you're here so you may be an inspiration and save the world for them. You're here right now in this place so you may save the world for Jesus Christ. But it's by your will to walk into what God is calling you to do. Amen. So my charge to you is give it all to Him. If you fall down, get back up. If you get weak, call on the Lord. You don't have to call on a man. You don't have to call on your family members. Call on Him. Wow. When you don't know what to do, I dare you just to call on Jesus. I dare you just to call on Him. Come on and give God some praise in this place. God bless hands. God bless hands in this place.
Thank you. Above all else, guard your heart, for it is the wellspring of life.
That's what it is. Guard your heart, for it is the wellspring of life. What does it say? We have to learn how to protect our heart. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's the thing that keeps us going. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
If your heart doesn't operate, that means you don't operate, correct?
Yes.
Keep going.
Put away perversity from your mouth. Keep corrupt thoughts from your lips. Let your eyes look straight ahead. Fix the day directly before you. Make level paths for your feet. And take only ways that are firm. Do not swerve to the right or the left. Keep your foot from evil.
Amen. Amen. Lord, you've got some praise in this place.
Amen.
I'm here to let you know, and I may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I'm here to let you know today that it's time to fight. It's time to fight. Let's actually have certain text today. Look at someone and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
It's time.
To
fight. One of the things that the word says in Proverbs is that we have to learn how to protect our hearts. Amen.
Yeah.
It's really hard sometimes because sometimes us as human beings, we get emotional. We have, you know, we get things, we have people that are attached to us. But I'm here to let you know that everybody can get close to your heart. Amen. Can I get a witness in this place? See, because some people don't know how to take care of your heart. Some people don't know how to take care of what God has for you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Yeah.
Say, protect,
protect
my heart.
My heart.
Lord.
Lord.
I'm here to let you know that this is the time that you have to learn how to protect your heart. We talked about that the enemy is here to learn how to do the three things, kill, steal, and what? Destroy. One of the ways that you can be killed is when the enemy ends up destroying your heart. Can I get a witness in this place? If your heart is punctured, you know, some matter of fact, my grandmother is going through, had open heart surgery, where she had a tear in her heart. And the crazy thing is that they had a sedator, and the process was not an in-and-out process. It took over 7 hours to fix a small little tear in her heart. I'm here to let you know that everybody can't get close to your heart, because the process of fixing your heart is crucial. Can I get a witness in this place? A lot of times we let folks in our hearts that we think is a good for a temporary fix. Or matter of fact, can I just be real for you for a second? Sometimes when we see someone that looks like a piece of meat or someone like a one-night stand, we let them to our place and we do whatever, and then we get emotionally attached to them. Can I get a witness in this place? I'm here to let you know that everybody can't be in the bed with you. Everybody can't be in the bed with you because you're emotionally attached. Your heart is there. Someone say, my heart.
My heart.
My heart, my heart, my heart. So you have to be careful who you let in your cliques. And you should be careful who you let around you. Write that down. Be careful who I let around me in 2010. We're coming to a critical stage, and it seems like you got to do a background check when people come to you.
Yeah.
But I'm here to let you know it's necessary. Why you say, what do you say, Pastor? Because everybody is not supposed to be your friend.
That's right.
The Bible says, love your neighbor, baby. I don't have to talk to you every day.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And I can love you from a distance. Can I get a witness in this place? But when you allow people to come in and puncture our heart, then hate begins to develop, right? So I'm here to let you know, baby, if I already know you drama, you messy, and you ain't supposed to be in my life, baby, bye, boo boo, I love you from a distance, because when you come into my life and you end up punching my heart, now I'm sinning because I hate you.
Oh, my Lord.
So the Bible says, put away that deceitfulness mouth, because we know our tongue will make us cuss.
Glory. Glory. Glory.
Mama.
my life, and baby, if you talk to me in one kind of way, I may cuss you out now. So I wish, can I get a witness in this place? Be careful what comes out of your mouth. God is saying, look, baby, watch out. So if I love you from a distance, I'll have to cuss you out. Can I get a witness in this place? So we have to learn how to protect ourselves. Because again, the heart is right here and the mouth is right there. Ain't that close? And it's almost like one of those you know, those fast track things. It's almost like it's just natural, especially when you start talking about folks' mamas. You say one thing about my mama, ready to fight. Can I get a witness? And so it says, preserve your lips. What do you do when you preserve something? Well, how do you preserve something? You gotta shut it, right? Some things you don't even have to talk for. He said, shut up. I'll handle it. Keep quiet. See, everything is not your battle. Everything is not for you to discuss and talk about all the time. Sometimes you got to learn how to give it up to God. Matter of fact, it's been folks that came in my life that have stood in my place that I knew I wanted to cuss out, but I just remained silent and let the Lord fight my battles. Can I get a witness in this place? It's hard. Yes, it is. But baby, when you give it to God, you feel like a better person at the end of the day. Because as much as they do their messiness and they stand in front of you and they smile on your face and stab you in the back the next moment, baby, at the end of the day, when God begins to deal with them, they go through the hell and tribulations while we're sitting here reminiscing on the glory of God and what God has done in our life, they're the ones that's like a fool. Can I get a witness in this place? And then it says, ponder your feet. And we have to look straight ahead. Someone say, look straight ahead.
Look straight ahead. Mm-hmm.
Baby, when you run a track, there's a straight course you got to go to. When you're running on the other side of the boat's track, you're running to people. Correct? You keep on running, you're on the grass. Someone say, stay
in
your lane. There's folks that need to stay in their lane. They worry about everybody else's business but their own. So can I get a witness in this place? God said, look straight ahead and let us do the thing. But we worry about what Pookie said. We worry about what everybody else said. But ourselves, stay in your lane. Stay in your lane. Because it ain't about anybody else. It's about me finishing this race. Can I get a witness in this place? You don't get no extra points when you're on the other lane. You don't get any other things when you're on the other folks' lanes. But Drake said it right. You're what? Disqualified. Can we just talk practical here? Because when you're running on a track and you start to run into the other folks' lanes, you're disqualified. Baby, I'm here to protect you. Don't get disqualified in a race. Can I get a witness in this place?
All right.
Don't get disqualified. Now, determination. What is the profound definition of determination? Well, determination is the inner fortitude and strength of character. So I say character. Being disciplined and remain constant, strong, and diligent regardless of the odds or demands. Determination is acting in faith when we temporarily lose sight of where we're going. A lot of times when you're running, sometimes sweat begins to get in your eyes and you can't see. But I'm here to let you know that you got to be determined to get the prize where God wants you to be. Someone say, I'm determined. Without determination, we find ourselves being tossed from here and there. And when the enemy comes against us, we don't know where to go. Now, when the pressure is on us, we find ourselves reacting in a way that we do not know how to fix. That means when someone comes in your face and talking all this drama, he said, she said, this whole fuck of messiness and all that kind of stuff, we get sidetracked because number one, we don't like mess sometimes. Can I get a witness? And then when mess is coming our way, we're ready to go ahead and cuss somebody out. Can I get a witness in this place? And I'm here to let you know that the enemy's here to do what? Kill, steal, and destroy. Destroy your home, destroy your family, kill your home, kill your family, kill yourself. And I'm here to let you know, stay determined. Someone say, stay determined, baby. I gotta stay in my lane. I gotta stay in my lane. I got to stay in my lane. Write down this 1 Corinthians 16:13. It says, watch, stand fast in faith, be brave, be strong. I'm here to let you know that the enemy is your word. You get what I'm saying? So when the enemy starts talking about you, you pick up your word, hallelujah. When you don't think you're going to make it anymore, look at 1 Corinthians when it says, watch and stand fast in faith. And be brave and be strong. That means when folks begin to talk about you, watch. Can I get a witness in this place? See, that's what I love about this B-I-B-L-E, because I can turn to Ephesians 6:13, where it says, therefore take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand an evil day, and having done to stand. Someone say, I'm standing. Baby, that Bible is here to protect you, and you got to understand, when you are a son or daughter of Jesus Christ, our son or daughter within the Lord, he's here to protect you. So it says, put on the whole armor of God. So when folks are talking about you, or when hell comes your way, baby, I dare you to pull up the whole armor of God. Someone say, I got to put on the whole armor of God. The thing that we must realize is that the devil is making a determined effort toward us, and he is more determined to keep us from moving forward than what God has for us. Someone said, we have to be determined. We have to be determined. Now, through a determined effort, we are to drive out our enemies. Oh my. What are you saying? Baby, everybody ain't supposed to be around you.
That's right.
Everybody, you don't have to minister to everybody.
Come on.
I'm here to let folks go. So if folks start acting crazy, I thank God for all the churches here in the United States of America. Because everybody, church is not for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. There's some churches that I know I won't go to, but some folks are in there. Mm-hmm. Okay? Now, we have strongholds in our lives that the enemy is trying to hold on to us to make a determined effort. What are you saying? The enemy has stuff on us. Yeah, because we did our dirt. And sometimes the enemy tries to pull up our dirt. Well, you say now, but you remember when you used to do this and you used to do that, you used to sleep with boo-hoo and so, or whatever. But maybe ain't about who I slept with, what I did back then, because the Bible says when I was a child, I done childish things, but when I became a man, I put down all my childish things away. So I'm here to let you know, when we mature in Christ, there's things that happen in our lives, amen. That means when I behaved as a child, I done childish things. That means when I was a messy person, I did messy things back then. When I was involved around drama, I dealt with drama. When I didn't have no money, I hung around broke folks. But baby, when I put down all my childish things, God became a man. Can I get a witness? So I'm here to let you know that you have to learn that greater is he that who is in us than who is in the world. Can I get a witness in this place? Because it ain't about him, it ain't about whoever in this room, but it's about him. Can I get a witness? The enemy doesn't really give up that easy. He's determined. So therefore, you have to realize that it takes a determined effort to defeat him. Because you know messy folks like messy, so they keep getting in your life and making up more stuff or whatever. You know, child, then you deal with gay folks too, that's messy. When you have clock setters in your life, folks that's trying to tear down what you got because they mad that you got something.
Oh my. Come on, Pastor.
But I'm here to let you know, when you are wrestling against principalities, against powers, against rules of darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts and wickedness of this heavenly place, you got to learn how to call on God.
Oh, my God.
Because, again, we turn our Bibles to Ephesians 6 and 12 and 13. It says, for we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rules of darkness of this age, against the whole. So therefore, we must do what? Take up the whole armor of God that you may be able to withstand an evil day. Many Christians fall in many areas because they do not know how to make a return to effort. In their marriages, in their relationships, in their children, in their jobs, in their business, in their ministry. Can I get a witness in this place? Burdens to sins, their prayer life is all messed up, all out of whack, and the enemy wants to continue to dwell in it. Can I get a witness? Someone said, I got to make a return to effort. So we have to learn how to stay in our lane. Mm-hmm. So I got to stay in my lane. I have to stay in my lane. So in order to stay in the lane, we got to learn how to trust and depend on God. Mm-hmm. Can I get a witness in this place? Mm-hmm. We have to. In order to make it, in order to get where we need to go to, we have to know how to give God it all. Amen? Because I'm here to let you know that when you learn how to call on Jesus, and Jesus is the only person that you're worried about, he's the one that will answer all of your calls. Can I get a witness in this place? I don't know about you, but I'm in the time and now that I only determine on what God has for me, because what God has for me is for me, and nobody can take it away. That means my relationship, no one can take it away. That means my job, no one can take it away. That means whatever God has for me is for me. Can I get a witness in this place? Say it in this place. What God has for me, it is for me. That means nobody can take away what God has for you. The relationship that's supposed to be yours, no one can take it away. The financial increase that's in your life, no one can take it away. You can make it what God has for me, it is for me. So you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to keep on running this race, and the enemy can't take me away. And I'm not looking to my left, and I'm not looking to my right. But I'm staying forward, and I keep on running, because baby, when I keep on running, watch God move, watch God lift me up. So talk about me as much as you want to, and watch God prevail. I dare somebody to stand up on your feet and give God some praise. If you know that you're right, if you know that your God prevails, tell your neighbor, say neighbor, I'm staying in my lane. Whether your neighbor say neighbor, stay in your lane. Say stay in your lane. Because you can't get in my stuff. Because what's mine, nobody can take it away. So I'm protecting everything in my lane. I wish I had some people in this place that know what I'm talking about. Every step I make for Jesus, he's taking me higher and higher. That means no one can take it away. Billy can't take it away. Joseph can't take it away. No one can take it away. Faith, what God has for you, it is for you. But the thing we got to do is learn how to stay in our lanes. Touch your neighbor and look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I got something that's in store for me, and I gotta stay in my lane. I can't be distracted. So neighbor, you gotta excuse me for a moment, because I gotta keep calling praise for what God got for me in my lane. You gotta watch out what God has for you. And when it's in your lane, baby, no one can take it away. That's why you want this water right here. Because see, when God begins to move, see, the Holy Ghost is like this. It's almost like you're running a marathon. Because when you're running, then God begins to come in your life. And when you're running, God said, look, hold up, let me give you some water. So you have enough energy to keep on running. I'm here to let you know. When we saw the song, God rain on us. He said he'll rain on you. If you stay on your lane, he'll rain on you. We don't worry about anything else. I'm here to let you know that God is going to pour out gotta say about me. I'm right in this place, and no one can take it away. I don't know about you, but when I get done running this race, I'm gonna give God it all, because I gotta give God truth. You know why? Because he took me this far for me not to quit now. I'm here to let you know, don't drop out, don't quit, pick up if you fall down, jumping over a hurdle, kick yourself back up, and jump back over it again. Can I get a witness in this place? I don't care how many hurdles you put in my way. I don't care how many trials you put in my way. I'm staying forward. I'm being determined. And I'm running this race. I don't know about you, but I got a race I got to run. I don't know about you, but I got to do what God called me to do. I don't know about you, but I'm here to let somebody know. But keep on running. Keep on running, keep on running, each and every day. Keep on running, keep on running, when you feel like you can't make it no more. Keep on running, keep on running, when you don't know how you're gonna make it. Keep on running, I don't care if you gotta take off your shoes, make it comfortable, baby, keep on running. Man, you're gonna take care of me. I'm here to let you know, because you are a champion. Touch your name and say, I'm a champion. I don't know about you, but I feel like I'm running for the United States Army. I'm in the Olympics, I'm sorry. And so, when you're going through training, because see, everybody just can't run.
That's right.
So you gotta go through something called training and practices and stuff. But I'm here to let you know, if you keep reading your Bible, and you know that in Philippians 4:13, that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I don't know about you, but when the hell comes my way, but I can't do it. I don't know about you, but I look at Philippians 4:13, and it says, Rashawn, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I'm here to let you know, you can do it, don't give up, you can do it, don't quit, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it, so don't give up, oh, what call out for you, keep on running, keep on fighting, keep on going, keep on going, because Jesus didn't quit, he hung on the cross, for your sins, and shed his blood for you and me. Can I get a witness in this place? If you know that he's mighty, if you know that he's powerful, come on and give God some praise. Hallelujah. He shed his blood for you and I, that we may be able to keep on running this race. I'm here to let you know that there's nobody that's gonna have me facing the wrong way. I'm gonna look ahead at the prize. And when you start tripping, I know I can pull up the whole armor of God and keep on running. I know I can pull up the whole armor of God and keep on going. I know I can pull up the whole armor of God and push through. Well, I'm here to go through. I'm here to let some people know. Maybe some of y'all in labor. Nobody worth that name. But you gotta keep on running. Come on and keep on running. Before you have a miscarriage, keep on running and have that baby. Keep on running and go with God. Talk to the coach. Keep on running and go and possess the land. To let you know, when things begin to get rough, you run the race, and you made it to the finish line. That's a good thing here, because once you make it to the finish line, you begin to win. I'm here to let you know, I'm here to win the gold, because when I get the gold, I'm not here to get a silver, I'm not here to get a bronze, Can I get a witness in this place for being high in it, God? The cool thing. Can I get a witness in this place? The cool thing is, once you get higher in God, there's a big celebration for you. That means I get a table and a room at the table. That I got everything that I want. And all the folks that talked about me, all the folks that said I wasn't going to make it, they sent all the way down there. I can't even see you because what all paths for me, it is for me. So I'm here to let you know. Once you're possessed with everything that God has for you, you don't have time to worry about everybody else, because I'm in the heavens, thanking God for everything that he's done in my life. Is there anybody in this place that know what I'm talking about? Is there anybody in this place that know what I'm saying? That means here, my mama, they don't like me right now because of the decisions I've made. I'm not going to let you know, but God, I live. For God, I die. Can I get a witness in this place? I thank God for his tender mercy. I thank God for his grace. I thank God for covering me. I thank God for raining down on me. I need to wave those hands and give it to God for waving down the blessings of life all over you. Come on, possess it. Come on, reach out for it. If you know it's yours, come on and get it. If you know you want it, give it to God. It's yours. It's yours. It's yours. It's yours. Everything you ever wanted. It's yours. The crazy thing is, some things are worth fighting for. I'm here to let you know you better fight for what's yours. You that once you fight, buddy, you got the biggest praise in the place. I don't care about you, but if I gotta praise him all by myself, I'll praise him. Because the God, he deserves the praise. He deserves it. Why? Because he brought me out of darkness into the marvelous light. That's why I like that song. That Jesus is the light. Because when I was blind and I couldn't see, God took off the veil, so I was able to run. Pour some water. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, keep on running. I dare you to keep on running. Because see, there's a difference when you run, and there's a difference when you walk. Baby, I got it somewhere I gotta be, and I gotta run to my blessing. I got somewhere I gotta be, and I gotta run to what God has for me. I got somewhere I gotta be, and I gotta run towards the mark. Church, your things I gotta press towards, and press towards the mark. Press towards what God has for you. Press towards the mark. Press toward the mark. See, I'm sorry that I'm so excited, because when folks said that Columbia wasn't going to make it, God opened up the windows in heaven and poured down a church on 7900 Neal Street. Not just a church, but a 300-seat sanctuary. Not just that, but a basketball court. I don't know about you, but if God said he'll do it for you, I know he'll do it. And he can do it for me. I know he can do it for you, but the thing is, don't get comfortable. Don't get comfortable, because again, the enemy's there to do what? Kill, steal, and destroy. So when you win the prize, just keep on running. I know you got the medal, but we got another race to win. And so when you got another race, just get ready for the hell to go through in your relationship. Get ready for the hell to go through in your finances. And he said, just like I got you out of debt, keep on running, and I'll give you another thing. Keep on running, and I'll bless you even more. Keep on running, and I'll provide you a place full of milk and honey. I don't know about you, but Paul said, open out the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing, God. for you to hold it. I'm here to let you know. Get ready to receive what God has for you. Get ready to receive it. And watch him open up the heavens and pour out a blessing into your life. Because we got called to everything we are. And God said, what the hell are you sitting down for? You got another race to win. But see, that's the thing. We get called with what we in. And God said, baby, I got more for you. You sitting there worried about that little thing right now. And I got something better in store for you. Get up and keep on running.
Jesus.
There's
something about the name Jesus when you go through a storm and you say, Jesus, things begin to really come down. But I'm here to let you know, if you just call on his name, in the time of trouble, if you call on his name, in the time of desperate despair, say, Jesus. See, there's something when you said that. See, some things just got broken just when you said it. Come on, say it one more time. Jesus. When folks come your way, it's full of mess and drama. I think to say, Jesus. Jesus. Shepherd, I feel God breaking some things in the rim of the atmosphere in this place. Jesus. Come on, say Jesus. Come on. Jesus. Come on, say his name. Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, say it's Jesus. Some things are being broken by calling on his name, Jesus. Come on, say Jesus. Come on, say Jesus. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. When you're in a time and you don't know how you're gonna make it, I dare you to call. I dare you to call. When I have no money, when I have no food, when I count on the God, I call his name. Come on, say Jesus. 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 When I go down and I have nothing to thinking about his stuff and what he gives to you. And so God says, you know, I know you have a hell of a job right now. But while you're working, think about me the whole entire time. Because when I give you something better in store, I don't want you to never forget what you got it for. Greenville. We'll be doing some revamping.
with that great work, it's going to take a lot of time, dedication, and work here. Amen. The Greenville is like it's going to take Columbia. And so, it's going to be nothing but an honor and a privilege to give my baby to the senior pastor of Freedom Worship Church Greenville, Pastor McDrake. Thank you.